Thank you for stopping by Healing Conversations with Z. I'm Zuri Bibi, and I'm going to do something I started doing on my channel a while ago when I first opened it up. I had stopped it for a while. But today, while doing some inner work, some really strong emotions came up. I still have the pain in my heart. I probably won't show my face. Been a lot of crying today, tears. But in case you all don't know, I channel via music, amongst other things. When I was listening to this song, a lot came up, and I've been listening to it all day because it's a message here for somebody. We all know that the energies are doing all this crazy stuff. Then they got us on lockdown. People have not been able to get with their counterparts, or people are finding out their counterparts are not who they said they were, or something has come up. However, I'm just going to do the reading and go from there. I'm not even sure if YouTube is going to put me on timeout. It is what it is. I'm just going to do it and go from there. I'll play the song and I'll shuffle a little bit. And my iPad is too far for me to turn the volume down. So I'm just going to push it back or something, and just do the cards from there. So here we go. I may play let the first verse or so play, and then I'll start actually putting the cards out. Heavy emotions. Just gonna pull one more card and then I'm gonna start talking. Somebody's going to have to be flexible with this situation. Somebody's a hangman because of a perception. There's some type of perception of being cheated on. They thought they were going to get four wands, but instead they got a pimp. Somebody that broke their heart. So they're detaching. They're moving away. They're not responding to any emotional interaction from whoever this person is. They are really in their emotions. They thought they were getting rewarded by this Knight of Wands that came in. There's a lot of hidden things going on behind the scenes. When they were with this person, somebody drinking right now, trying to balance their emotions out. And they're trying to get some clarity on what's going on. Because there's two women in this picture, so there's two women that's going on in this situation. Trying to get their strength. They're trying to be determined. And they're trying to get some clarity. Let's clarify these. Nine of Cups. They're trying to get some clarity because here's this moon, this hidden stuff about this, what they thought that they were getting. They thought they were getting Nine of Cups. Can I get one on the Four of Wands? Yeah, they thought they were getting the Four of Wands. They really did. And whoever this Don Juan was, Knight of Wands was, he was very controlling. Can I have one for the Six of Swords? One for Six of Swords. Only one. I got more messages coming. Six of Wands. One. Hard-headed. I'm taking this one. Ten of Wands. Overburdened. Detaching. Walk. This can't. It's just too much. Mentally, there. I'm not taking these. Four Cups. Detaching. Yeah, there's something about pentacles trying to, they're detaching so they can work on their pentacles. Money. And they're going deep within to figure out how to do that after what's going on with the Knight of Wands. Nine of Pentacles. Look at that. Yeah. They're moving in another direction. They're changing the wheels of the world. And this is a cycle. It's two lambeskes. Well, actually, it's more than that. And there are things that will blossom for them, but right, you know, right now they're trying to get over whatever this heartbreak. Trying to figure out how to be flexible and look at things from a different perspective. Can I have one for the moon? I'll take that one that fell over there. Oh, it's in reverse. Four Swords is in reverse. They're coming out of slumber about this. They're beginning mentally. They're getting clarity on what was going on. Can I have one for the Hermit? No, I'm not taking all of that. No, one for the Temperance. They want to be passionate about, you know, we're taking action or not to respond. Balancing out responding in a negative way. Knight of Swords. Knight of Swords. Can I have one? For the only one. Y'all like to talk. Still got two. Daughter of Swords. These are shrewd. This is family. This is family. Very shrewd. Whatever was going on is family related. And they were very passionate about it. Whatever this is, this heartbreak that's going on, wherever it is. And this orbs around this person's soul. And those are the chakra colors. She was passionately, whatever it is family. Yeah. Anyway, Ace of Wands. Gonna have one for the Ace of Wands. You're sad. You're sad about this. Because you were blindsided. Queen of Wands. How are you trying to be determined? How are you being determined? You're trying to gather your emotions. Trying to get it together. And work on your chakras. Because those are the chakra colors. And the Ace of Swords, reverse Two of Cups. You know for sure that this is not what's going on. This is what most people want, but this is what's happening right now. No Two of Cups. None. That you're clear about, because this two of Swords is upright. These two Swords are upright. You're clear about that. You're clear. No Two of Cups. I'm pulling out this other deck. Dark Mirror to find out why this is possibly taking place now. I don't have the book with me right now. But the Temple of your body. And what this looks like is somebody is scratching. And they didn't protect their body. Whoever this knight was, you know, he just ransacked through the temple and just beat you down. This looks like this person's dying and their soul is coming out. That's how they feel. So it's some type, you know, calling in the storm. It's just the whole, you got to get out of this energy because if they're calling in a storm, that means they're calling in more negative energy. You got to get out of this. And you got to learn how to be true to your heart, because right now, that's part of the reason why you got into this situation, because you weren't true to your heart. You were being very fake and artificial. And there was some type of obsession with this situation as well. And now that you know that the way it is turning out, you know, you're embarrassed, downcast pride, because you see that it was some kind of masquerade taking place at your expense. Oh. See what the angels have to say. These are the angels on the tree of life, seeing what's going to happen right now. I knew I was going to need this deck to help balance out the message. Okay, Angelarium, what do you have to say about this? How can this be helped? Angel of Snow, right now, whoever it is, right now, the best thing for them to do is to get cold. That means to detach. You see how her face is covered. But there's like this little veil. You can't detach, though. Yeah, that's her dark side. Somebody is having some... They're working with the light and the dark. But they're still protecting themselves some kind of way with this. Okay, what else? What else can they do? Don't worry, Angel of Annihilation is here. So whatever, you're going to have victory. This angel comes in to annihilate whatever evilness is around you, because you know that you're protected. And you know that we're always surrounded by angels. But right now, whoever this is, you know, they are devastated about this. And in their mind, this is what they want. Don't be in this energy. You don't have to do that. You already protected. You protected. This is KETER. This is the top of the tree of life. This is up in the ethers. You are safe. He's watching over these activities. So don't worry about it. While you're going through whatever it is, it's going to get you back in line with your spirituality, because apparently that's what happened. You kind of lost your way. One, maybe two more. If you're gonna give me one. No. Nope, Mr. The angel KETER say you got this. You ain't giving me no more of those. And you see how he has his hands up in prayer. He is the Most High. This is up at the beginning of the tree of life. This is the very first angel, and he's over the four of wands. This card fell right over the four of wands, so he has you covered, even though you don't feel like it. Kind of changed some things up for a minute. ask a question and I'm not going to take them. But it has something to do with lovers, like I told you. Where am I at? What's going on here? Can we switch this around? How can we switch this around? You're gonna have to go through the tower. You're gonna have to go through it. And you're gonna have to move away. My last reading, I said that. You're gonna have to move away. Because you feel like you are bound to this person. You're not bound to anybody. And these birds are trying to tell you that. They're trying to pull it off. I'm not taking these cards, but I'm just, I know that they all were the right way up, and I want to make sure they go back the right way. There's some type of transformation going on. It's going to transform the Ten of Wands, because that's where it's falling over, the Ten of Wands. And by doing that, it's going to allow you to move forward, but you're going to have to do this inner child work. You're going to have to do it. And when you do it, it'll change your world. It may allow you, if you do right, to get in union with yourself. Never mind the Knight of Wands. Never mind him. Let's just focus on you. And this is the Page of Cups. And I call this the When Pigs Fly card. I say that because there is a pig flying. And it may give you the new beginning. But this emotions will help you get over this masquerade that you've been playing. You've been playing a game. And you need to transform, because that's what's happening here. He's being lifted up to deal with his emotions. When pigs fly, they're flying now, so that means you need to get on it. Yeah, because whatever, it was a lot of choices going on, and they weren't the right ones. You didn't make the right ones. This is what you want. You want to be Queen of Cups. This is what you want to do. You do your inner work. It'll help you move up. Because you were a page of cups. Now you're Queen of Cups. And by doing that will help you have victory in this situation with yourself. Not with the other person. You're not dealing the other person. They in this negative energy right now. That's what they did. They did that to you. These cards now are helping you to get out of that energy. You have to do the work. You have to go back and heal whatever it is that made you think that what they were doing was appropriate, was acceptable. Because right now you are out in the cold. But at least you're going within. Once you lift your head up, you'll see this key here that will allow you to open the door back up. And then your world will change for the better. See, she's smiling, whereas before, this is what you want. And those symbols are the platonic solids, part of the tree of life, part of sacred geometry. And there's a circle there that's part of, that's the one part of a cycle. But this isn't that type of reading right now. This is just, and there's the flower, seed of life behind her. Sorry about the glare. That seed of life will, you and that seed of life, as long as you're in that seed of life, you will always have what you need. You won't have to ask nobody for nothing. And you see she's in here all by herself. All by herself. There's nobody else there. So you won't have to deal with, if you don't want to, you don't have to deal with nobody else. And that will allow you to be in this energy where you're passionately doing your thing, not what other people want. I'm pulling out this plant medicine. And I'll name the card, but I'm gonna name the medicine. So, because of this tower, you're gonna need strength, which is garlic. And you need to look these up, look these herbs up, because they'll tell you what they can do. Garlic is strong. It can kill fungus and all kind of cooties. And this will allow you to have peach tea, happiness. Nine of cups is happiness. And that, you know, once you walk away, that's what you will. You know, this is how you're going to heal yourself, by peach. Eight of swords. It's going to heal you. You're going to heal this eight of swords. This is interesting. I'm going to pull it up. This person feels bound by these wires. This person's healing because they're building. You will heal what's going on here. You'll heal your earthly environment. Sweet grass. How are you going to transform? How that going to take place? You're going to transform your wheel of fortune. And this is kitchen garden. Yep. This is how you're going to heal yourself. The chariot. How are you going to heal the chariot? I'm going to take them. You're going, by moving forward, you'll be able to get into this witch hazel, which is healing. Witch hazel is an astringent. It's a healer. You'll have the two of earth. You'll be able to have an idea what you're going to do on this earth. It won't be for sure, but you'll have a better idea. Oh, you will. You'll begin to have an understanding of what you, and you'll be able to work on yourself. Raspberry. After dealing with the devil, this is you're gonna repair yourself with this witch hazel. You're gonna repair yourself from having this three of pentacle devil energy, because that's what it was. You're gonna move away from that, because that's what happened. Whoever it was, whoever you were dealing with, they were working with that person. This is somebody they were working with. The world. Yeah, because that devil energy, this is in reverse. This is the page of air. Hija of air is a young energy where they are ready to learn, but because you were in this devil energy, you weren't able to do that. You were blocked from doing that, so it affected your world. And what is that? That's catnip. And the devil is blackberry, just so you know. And because you were blocked on the world, it affected your child, your inner child, your ability to deal with whatever inner child issues you were having. Oh, I did not expect this reading to be this long. Six of Pentacles is being stable, having enough to share and share with others. You know, if you can get into this Four of Wands energy, you'll be able to be successful where you can help others if you want to. What I like about these cards is there's nobody else in these cards. Nobody. Page of Cups. Four of Air. Lavender. Oh, I didn't tell you this was pine. Four of Air. This is lavender. Lavender is healing. Lavender will allow you to relax. Lavender has astringent capabilities as well. And while you are lifting out of those emotions that you were in, the when pigs fly energy, this lavender is going to pop in and calm you and give you some rest, help you rest. And the Queen of Cups is going to go into hermit mode. And that's usnea. That herb is usnea. And that will allow you to go to sleep. You're going to rest. This will relax you. This lavender will relax you. But this usnea is going to put you to sleep. So you can really, really, really think back on what you missed, to allow the dark energy to come in to confuse you or not allow you to see what you really were supposed to see. Six of Wands. How are we gonna, what energy, what herb is going to help that? Yarrow. Clarity. You'll be successful, be able to be successful because you have clarity. And that's card Yarrow. Five of Pentacles. It was sideways. But I saw this before I even started this reading, the tower. But it was right side up. So once you get the clarity, you'll get out of this tower. And this is mushrooms. Mushrooms will tear up some stuff. You know, plants and stuff. They will. All right. And the last card is the World. This will allow you to have your Ten of Pentacles. And that's horsetail. Very abundant. It's a very abundant herb or plant that we use here on Earth. And on the bottom of the deck, listen to me, that's just crazy. The bottom of the deck is Ace of Fire. Ace of Fire. So, just know KETER has you. That's all I'm going to say. Just know that KETER has you. You're going to get out of this. I want to thank you all for watching, stopping by. I hadn't done this in a while. I just hope that this gives somebody some clarity on what's going on and not to remain in the negative energy. Regroup passionately. And know that you have the knowledge now. You have the knowledge that you need now. Which angel is this? Bina, left eye. You have the knowledge that you need. And there's an orb holding something. That's a pearl. That's who you are. You are a pearl. Know that. Yes, whatever happened, happened, but know that you are the pearl. Alright, you all take care. Thank you for stopping by Healing Conversations with Z. Peace.